the song Last Kiss, the band Pearl Jam. They just took the song off a record somewhere in a shop that no one's ever heard of, and they thought, you know what, this is the biggest hit ever. And this is their biggest hit up to date. So let's dig into it. First of all, very, very basic chords. Probably the four most basic chords that you've ever heard in your life, that you'll find in any chord chart. The first chord is probably the G. You can play it like this, or you could just add a ring finger, this one over here for the single guys, on the third fret just above the pinky. It's not wrong, it's just a different kind of a G. And then for the second chord, the E minor, we do this, the evil chord again. We have that going over there. The C is over here. And then for the last chord we have a D. Now, this is not really the way I'd play it. I'd use a few more chords or just a little different chord here and there. But you can start off with these. The E minor that I use is over here. It's basically your E minor with the extra two notes right at the bottom. So what we do is we take these first two fingers, replace them there, and put these right at the bottom. It's an E minor 7 sharp 9. You don't have to know that, as long as you know that you can use it, you're right for now. And then the C that I'm using is this C, coming not from here, but right over there. After using the E minor 7, I go right over there to the C, which is actually a C at 9, and then straight from there I go into the D. So look at my ring finger. Right through the whole song, it stays on that one fret, on that same note. Check it out. This is the G, the E minor 7, C at 9, and D. So the ring finger is your bass. You can actually start with putting the finger down there, and that will help a hell of a lot. Now, before we dig into too many detail here, let's start with the right hand. The right hand is actually very, very easy. What we do, we count 1, 2, 3, 4, if you can put the ands in between. So it's 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. That's the very basic for playing rhythm guitar. And now you must just play some of these beats that we have. First of all, take your left hand, put it softly on the strings. Very softly, so that when you do that, it gives you a scratching kind of sound. We also call that a scratch, by the way, that over there. So we can hear the rhythm very nicely before we even put the chords in. Here we go for the rhythm. It's always count first. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. I'm going to do that again. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. So it's on beat 1 and 2 and. That's the trick. 1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and. And that's very much also what the drums play. Doof ka doof doof ka doof ka doof doof ka for this song. Well, at least the Pearl Jam version. Then, putting it all together, we do this. Make a nice big movement on the right hand side. It will help you relax while you play and keep that beat very consistent. It's a little bit slow, but it's easier that way for now. Now, you can do a little bit more with the right hand, and that is an extra stop there on B2, I think. Let's just check that out. That's correct, B2. So you go. Now, when you stop, you kind of stop, but you don't want to go out of this rhythm that you have. So you stop while playing down, and you mute with the side of your hand. You mute right over there. It's touching at the bottom right there as I go down on B2. So it is, that's 1 and B2 stopped. And also on the 4. It makes it a bit more rhythmic, and if you're a guy sitting around a campfire somewhere, you're entertaining your friends, you don't have a drummer with you, you might as well just put that in. So you're playing a little bit of drums as well. And so on. Now, just before we get to the chorus, we have at the end of this section where you play these four chords, you have a two bar G that sounds like this. And the drums playing another bar, doof, ga, doof, doof, ga. And then the howling sound. And the same chords and the same rhythm. That's not too difficult. So go try that at home. See you next time.